If you're watching this video, it's not a coincidence. God is trying to get your attention. As a chosen one, your life is filled with moments where the divine reaches out to guide, protect, and awaken you to your higher purpose. But often, in the hustle and bustle of everyday life, these divine messages can go unnoticed. This video is a reminder, a signal from the universe, that you are on a path of great significance. You are unique, chosen, and called to fulfill a mission that only you can accomplish. Everyday life is full of distractions, work, relationships, social obligations, and the constant noise of the modern world. Yet, amidst all this, God is continuously sending you signs, nudging you to pay attention to the deeper truths that lie beneath the surface. Whether it's through a sudden insight, a recurring dream, or an unexpected encounter, these moments are meant to awaken you to your divine calling. The very fact that you are here, watching this video, is a testament to the fact that God is trying to get your attention. So, take a moment to breathe, focus, and open your heart to the message that is being sent to you today. Before we dive into the chapters, remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment with the number 77 foot to send a signal to the universe. This small act aligns your energy with the divine intention and amplifies the message being delivered to you. And don't forget, you can play this video on repeat, even in the background, to ensure that all the energy and wisdom it contains are fully absorbed and sent out into the universe. This is an important practice that will help you stay connected to your higher purpose. Chapter 1: Recognizing the Divine Signs in Everyday Life. The journey of a chosen one is deeply intertwined with the divine, and recognizing the signs that God is trying to get your attention is a fundamental part of that journey. These signs are often woven into the fabric of your everyday life, appearing in subtle and sometimes unexpected ways. However, because they are so intricately connected to the mundane, they can easily be overlooked or dismissed as coincidences if you're not paying attention. As a chosen one, your heightened sensitivity to the spiritual world gives you a unique advantage, but it's essential to cultivate an awareness that allows you to notice, interpret, and act upon these divine messages. In the rush of daily life, it's easy to get caught up in routines and distractions, causing you to miss the subtle cues that God is placing in your path. These cues can manifest in various forms, each carrying its own significance and meaning. For instance, you might find yourself repeatedly encountering the same song, number sequence, or phrase in different contexts. While these occurrences may seem trivial on the surface, they are often deliberate signs from the divine, meant to capture your attention and convey a deeper message. It could be a call to reflect on your current path, a gentle nudge to explore a new direction, or even a warning to reconsider a decision you are about to make. The key to recognizing these signs is to remain open and receptive, trusting that nothing happens by accident in your spiritual journey. Consider the moments in your life when someone seemingly random entered your world at precisely the right time, offering advice, support, or an opportunity that aligned perfectly with your needs. These encounters are not mere chance, they are orchestrated by God to assist you on your journey. Such individuals often act as messengers, delivering divine wisdom through their words and actions. When you experience these synchronistic events, take a moment to reflect on their significance. Is there a recurring theme in your conversations, or do you keep receiving the same piece of advice from different sources? These patterns are not to be ignored, as they often point to areas in your life that require your attention or adjustment. The natural world is another powerful channel through which God communicates with you. Nature is teeming with symbols, omens, and signs that can guide you on your spiritual path. For example, if a particular animal crosses your path repeatedly, it may serve as a totem or spirit guide, offering you its unique wisdom. Similarly, natural phenomena like sudden changes in weather, the appearance of specific plants, or even the shape of a cloud can carry messages meant for you. By attuning yourself to the rhythms of nature, you can begin to decipher these subtle messages and understand what the divine is trying to convey. Spend time in nature, whether through a quiet walk in the park or a moment of stillness by a body of water, and open your heart to the whispers of the divine that flow through the environment. Dreams are yet another profound way that God reaches out to you. While you sleep, your conscious mind rests, allowing your subconscious to receive and process messages from the divine without the interference of waking thoughts and concerns. Pay close attention to your dreams, particularly those that feel unusually vivid, emotionally charged, or that recur over time. These dreams are often rich with symbolism and can provide invaluable insights into your spiritual journey. Keeping a dream journal is an excellent practice for tracking these messages. By recording your dreams and reflecting on them, you can identify recurring symbols, themes, and patterns that offer guidance or warnings for your waking life. As you navigate your day-to-day experiences, cultivating a practice of mindfulness can greatly enhance your ability to recognize divine signs. Mindfulness is the art of being fully present in each moment, allowing you to observe your thoughts, feelings, and surroundings without judgment or distraction. When you practice mindfulness, you become more attuned to the subtle shifts in energy, the synchronicities, and the intuitive nudges that God uses to communicate with you. Whether it's a chance encounter with a stranger, an unexpected event, or a feeling of déjà vu, staying mindful allows you to perceive these occurrences as the divine messages they truly are. Intuition plays a crucial role in this process. Your intuition is a direct connection to the divine, a built-in compass that guides you toward truth and clarity. When something feels significant or resonates deeply within you, even if you can't logically explain why, trust that feeling. Your intuition is often the first to recognize divine signs, even before your conscious mind can make sense of them. The more you listen to and trust your intuition, the stronger and more accurate it becomes, enabling you to understand the messages that God is sending you with greater precision. It's important to recognize that divine signs can also come in the form of challenges or obstacles. Sometimes, when a path is blocked or a situation becomes difficult, it's a sign that God is steering you away from something that isn't aligned with your highest good. These challenges, though uncomfortable, are often opportunities for growth and realignment with your true purpose. By approaching obstacles with an open heart and mind, you can discern the underlying message and use it to guide your next steps. In summary, recognizing the divine signs in your everyday life is a vital skill for any chosen one. These signs are all around you, embedded in your daily experiences, interactions, and the natural world. By practicing mindfulness, trusting your intuition, and remaining open to the possibility that nothing is random, you can begin to see and interpret these signs with greater clarity. Remember, these signs are not just random occurrences, they are intentional communications from God, meant to guide you on your path. Embrace them with gratitude, and let them lead you closer to the fulfillment of your divine purpose. Chapter 2: The Power of Divine Timing. Understanding the concept of divine timing is crucial for recognizing how and when God is trying to get your attention. As a chosen one, your life operates on a different timeline than that of the ordinary world. While others may be focused on immediate results or adhering to societal deadlines, you are being guided by a higher power that sees the bigger picture. Divine timing is the notion that everything in your life happens at the exact moment it is meant to, according to God's plan. This timing is not always aligned with your personal desires or the pressures of the world around you, but it is always perfect in its purpose. One of the challenges of living by divine timing is the need to cultivate patience and trust. In a world that prizes speed and efficiency, it can be difficult to accept that some things simply cannot be rushed. However, when you learn to trust in divine timing, you begin to see that delays and detours are not obstacles, but rather essential parts of your journey. They serve to prepare you, to build your character, and to align you more closely with your divine purpose. For instance, you might feel frustrated when a job opportunity doesn't pan out or a relationship ends unexpectedly. But in hindsight, you may realize that these experiences were necessary to steer you toward something far greater. divine timing also manifests in the synchronicities that occur in your life. These are those seemingly random moments when everything just falls into place, when you meet the right person at the right time, or when an opportunity presents itself just as you need it. These synchronicities are not mere coincidences, they are evidence of divine orchestration. They show you that God is actively involved in your life, guiding you toward the fulfillment of your destiny. Pay close attention to these moments, as they are often markers on your path, confirming that you are exactly where you need to be. It's also important to recognize that divine timing is not just about big life events, it operates in the small, everyday moments as well. Have you ever found yourself stuck in traffic, only to later discover that your delay prevented you from being involved in an accident? Or perhaps you've experienced a sudden change in plans, only to realize that the new plan led you to a serendipitous encounter or discovery. These instances are reminders that even when things seem to be going wrong, they are actually unfolding exactly as they should according to divine timing. To align yourself with divine timing, it's essential to develop a practice of surrender. Surrendering does not mean giving up or resigning yourself to fate. Rather, it means releasing the need to control every aspect of your life and trusting that God's plan for you is far greater than anything you could imagine. This trust is not passive, it requires active faith, where you take inspired action when the time is right and remain patient when things are not moving as quickly as you'd like. By surrendering to divine timing, you allow God to work in your life without the interference of your fears, doubts, or impatience. Divine timing also teaches you the importance of seasons in your life. Just as nature goes through cycles of growth, harvest, decay, and renewal, so too do you experience different seasons in your spiritual journey. There are times of planting, where you sow seeds of intention and work diligently toward your goals. There are times of waiting, where growth happens beneath the surface, unseen but vital. And there are times of harvest, where your efforts come to fruition and you reap the rewards of your patience and perseverance. Understanding these seasons allows you to flow with the natural rhythms of life, rather than resisting or trying to force things to happen outside of their proper time. Another aspect of divine timing is the concept of divine delays. These are periods where it seems like nothing is happening, where you might feel stuck or in a state of limbo. While these delays can be frustrating, they often serve a higher purpose. They are times of preparation, where you are being refined and shaped for what is to come. It's during these moments that you are called to deepen your faith, to trust that God is working behind the scenes, even if you can't see the results yet. These delays are not setbacks, but rather divine pauses, giving you the opportunity to grow, learn, and align yourself more closely with your higher purpose. In embracing divine timing, it's important to release the need for immediate answers or results. Society often pressures you to have everything figured out, to know your path, and to move toward it with relentless speed. But as a chosen one, your journey is not about conforming to societal expectations, it's about walking a path that is uniquely yours, guided by the hand of the divine. This path requires you to cultivate patience, trust, and a deep sense of faith that everything is unfolding as it should, in its own perfect time. In conclusion, the power of divine timing lies in its ability to align your life with God's greater plan for you. By recognizing and trusting in divine timing, you open yourself up to the flow of life, allowing things to unfold in their own perfect way. Whether through synchronicities, divine delays, or the natural seasons of life, divine timing is always working in your favor, guiding you toward the fulfillment of your destiny. Embrace this timing with patience and trust, knowing that every moment is part of a divine plan that is far greater than anything you could imagine. Chapter 3: Embracing the Stillness and Silence. In a world that constantly demands action, noise, and progress, the moments of stillness and silence can feel uncomfortable, even unsettling. However, for chosen ones, these moments are sacred opportunities to connect with the divine. When God is trying to get your attention, it's often in the quiet spaces of your life that you can hear His voice most clearly. Embracing stillness and silence is not just about physical quiet, but about cultivating an inner state of calm where the divine can speak to your heart and soul without the distractions of the external world. Stillness is a gift, though it's often overlooked or undervalued in a society that glorifies business. Yet, it's in the stillness that you can truly listen to yourself, to your intuition, and to God. When you allow yourself to pause, to step away from the constant stream of information, tasks, and responsibilities, you create space for the divine to enter. This doesn't mean you have to meditate for hours or retreat to a remote location, though those can be valuable practices. It's about finding moments throughout your day where you can quiet your mind, even if just for a few minutes, and tune into the subtle whispers of the divine. Silence, like stillness, can be a powerful tool for spiritual growth. In silence, you can hear the truth that lies beneath the surface noise of your mind. This truth is often where God's messages are found. When you embrace silence, you allow yourself to hear what is truly important, what your soul needs to know. This might come as a sudden insight, a feeling of peace, or a deep knowing that doesn't require words. Silence strips away the superficial, revealing the core of what God is trying to communicate to you. For many, the idea of being still or silent can be daunting. We are conditioned to fill every moment with activity, to keep our minds occupied and our bodies busy. But for chosen ones, the ability to embrace stillness and silence is essential. It's in these moments that you can connect with your true self and with the divine source that guides you. When you feel overwhelmed, uncertain, or lost, it's often a sign that you need to return to stillness, to find a quiet place within yourself where you can reconnect with God. One of the greatest benefits of embracing stillness and silence is the clarity it brings. When you quiet the external noise, you can hear your inner voice more clearly. This voice is your intuition, your direct connection to the divine. In stillness, you can discern between the voice of your ego, which is often driven by fear and insecurity, and the voice of your soul, which speaks from a place of love and wisdom. This clarity is crucial when God is trying to get your attention, as it allows you to receive His messages without distortion or confusion. Stillness and silence also provide the space for deep reflection. When you take the time to sit with your thoughts and feelings without judgment, you can gain insight into your current situation, your relationships, and your spiritual path. Reflection allows you to process the experiences and challenges you've faced and to understand the lessons they offer. It's through this process of reflection that you can begin to see the patterns in your life and recognize the ways in which God has been guiding you all along. Another important aspect of stillness is its ability to foster a sense of peace and grounding. In the stillness, you can reconnect with the earth, with your body, and with the present moment. This grounding is essential for chosen ones, as it helps you stay centered and balanced, even in the midst of chaos or uncertainty. When you are grounded, you are more resilient, more able to navigate the challenges of life with grace and composure. This inner stability allows you to remain open to divine guidance, even when the path ahead is unclear. Silence, too, has its own unique power. In a world filled with constant noise, finding moments of true silence can be a profound experience. In silence, you can hear the beating of your own heart, the rhythm of your breath, and the subtle vibrations of life all around you. This attunement to the deeper rhythms of existence can help you feel more connected to the divine, more attuned to the messages that are being sent your way. Silence allows you to tune out the distractions and tune into the divine frequency that is always present, always available to guide you. Embracing stillness and silence is not about retreating from the world, but about finding a deeper connection to it. When you cultivate these practices, you become more present, more aware of the divine in every aspect of your life. You start to see the sacredness in the ordinary, the holiness in the everyday moments that might otherwise go unnoticed. This heightened awareness allows you to recognize when God is trying to get your attention, even in the most mundane situations. In conclusion, stillness and silence are powerful tools for chosen ones. They allow you to connect with the divine, to hear God's messages more clearly, and to find the clarity and peace that are essential for your spiritual journey. By embracing these moments of quiet, you open yourself up to a deeper understanding of yourself, your path, and your connection to the divine. Remember, it's often in the stillness and silence that the most profound revelations come, that the voice of God can be heard most clearly. So, take the time to cultivate these practices, and let them guide you on your path as a chosen one. Chapter 4: The Role of Intuition and Inner Guidance. Intuition is a powerful tool that God has gifted to the chosen ones, serving as a direct line of communication between you and the divine. It's that inner knowing, that gut feeling that often guides you when logic and reason fail to provide answers. When God is trying to get your attention, He often does so through your intuition, nudging you toward the right path, even when it doesn't make sense to your rational mind. Trusting and honing your intuition is essential for staying aligned with your divine purpose and recognizing the signs and messages that are meant for you. Your intuition is your spiritual compass, guiding you toward the people, situations, and opportunities that are in alignment with your soul's purpose. It's that inner voice that tells you when something feels right or wrong, even if you can't explain why. Often, intuition communicates in subtle ways, through a feeling of peace or discomfort, a sudden insight, or a strong urge to take a particular action. As a chosen one, it's crucial to listen to these intuitive prompts, as they are often the way God steers you in the right direction. However, trusting your intuition can sometimes be challenging, especially in a world that values logic and tangible evidence. You may find yourself doubting your inner guidance, questioning whether it's real or if you're just imagining things. But it's important to remember that intuition is not something that can always be explained or understood through conventional means. It's a form of inner wisdom that transcends logic, connecting you directly to the divine source. The more you trust and act on your intuition, the stronger and more accurate it becomes. One way to strengthen your intuition is through regular practice and mindfulness. By paying attention to the subtle cues and signals that arise within you, you begin to develop a deeper understanding of how your intuition communicates. This might involve noticing the physical sensations in your body when you think about a certain decision, observing the emotions that arise when you're in different situations, or simply taking the time to reflect on the outcomes when you follow your intuition versus when you ignore it. Over time, you'll start to recognize the patterns and develop a stronger sense of trust in your inner guidance. Another key to enhancing your intuition is to quiet the mind. A noisy, cluttered mind can drown out the voice of intuition, making it difficult to discern the divine messages that are being sent your way. Practices such as meditation, deep breathing, and journaling can help you clear your mind and create the space needed for your intuition to emerge. When you regularly engage in these practices, you'll find that your intuition becomes more accessible, offering insights and guidance even in the midst of chaos or uncertainty. It's also important to note that intuition is closely linked to your emotions. Your emotions serve as a barometer, indicating whether something is in alignment with your higher self or not. When you feel joy, excitement, or a sense of peace, it's often a sign that you are on the right path. Conversely, feelings of anxiety, dread, or discomfort can indicate that something is out of alignment with your true purpose. By tuning into your emotions and using them as a guide, you can better understand the messages your intuition is trying to convey. One of the most powerful aspects of intuition is its ability to guide you in situations where there is no clear answer. There will be times in your life when you are faced with difficult decisions, where the path ahead is uncertain, and where logic alone cannot provide the answers you seek. In these moments, your intuition becomes your greatest ally. It can help you navigate through the fog of uncertainty, leading you toward the choices that are in your highest good. Trusting your intuition during these times is a testament to your faith in the divine plan for your life. It's also worth mentioning that intuition often works in tandem with divine timing. There may be times when you feel an intuitive nudge to take a particular action, but the timing doesn't seem right. In these cases, it's important to trust that your intuition is guiding you in alignment with divine timing. This might mean that you need to be patient and wait for the right moment to act, or it might mean that you need to take a leap of faith, even if the timing seems unconventional. By trusting both your intuition and divine timing, you align yourself more fully with the flow of the universe and the path that God has set for you. As you continue to cultivate and trust your intuition, you'll find that it becomes an indispensable part of your spiritual journey. It will guide you through challenges, help you recognize divine signs, and lead you to the people and experiences that are meant to shape your life. Remember that your intuition is a gift from God, a direct line of communication that allows you to navigate your path as a chosen one with confidence and clarity. In conclusion, intuition and inner guidance are essential tools for chosen ones. They allow you to stay connected to the divine, to recognize when God is trying to get your attention, and to make decisions that are in alignment with your higher purpose. By trusting and honing your intuition, you open yourself up to the flow of divine wisdom, allowing it to guide you toward the fulfillment of your destiny. Embrace your intuition as a sacred gift, and let it lead you on your journey with faith and confidence. Chapter 5: The Significance of Spiritual Discernment. Spiritual discernment is the ability to perceive and understand the spiritual forces at play in your life, allowing you to differentiate between divine guidance and distractions or deceptions that may lead you astray. As a chosen one, developing strong spiritual discernment is crucial for navigating your path and recognizing when God is trying to get your attention. Discernment helps you to see beyond the surface, to understand the true nature of the situations and people you encounter, and to make decisions that align with your highest good. In today's world, where there are countless voices and influences vying for your attention, discernment is more important than ever. You are constantly bombarded with information, opinions, and advice, not all of which is in alignment with your spiritual path. Without discernment, it's easy to become overwhelmed or misled, to follow paths that seem promising but ultimately lead you away from your true purpose. This is why discernment is often described as a spiritual muscle that needs to be exercised and strengthened so that you can navigate your journey with clarity and confidence. One of the first steps in developing discernment is to cultivate a deep relationship with God. This relationship forms the foundation of your ability to discern, as it allows you to recognize His voice and guidance amidst the noise of the world. Prayer, meditation, and regular communion with the divine are essential practices for deepening this relationship. The more time you spend in God's presence, the more familiar you become with His ways, His truths, and His will for your life. This familiarity is what allows you to discern when something is truly from God and when it is not. Another important aspect of discernment is understanding that not all that glitters is gold. In your journey as a chosen one, you will encounter many opportunities, people, and situations that seem appealing on the surface. However, discernment requires you to look beyond appearances, to seek the truth that lies beneath. This might mean asking yourself difficult questions, seeking guidance from trusted spiritual mentors, or spending time in prayer and reflection before making a decision. It's about being willing to dig deeper, to uncover the motives, intentions, and potential consequences of any given situation. Discernment also involves recognizing the difference between intuition and fear. While intuition is a form of divine guidance, fear is often a reaction of the ego, designed to keep you safe but not necessarily aligned with your higher purpose. Fear can cloud your judgment, causing you to make decisions based on anxiety or a desire to avoid discomfort. Discernment allows you to distinguish between the two, to recognize when fear is trying to hold you back versus when intuition is guiding you forward. This distinction is crucial, as it ensures that your decisions are made from a place of wisdom and clarity, rather than fear or insecurity. One of the challenges of discernment is that it often requires you to go against the grain, to make choices that are not popular or easily understood by others. As a chosen one, you are called to a higher standard, and this often means walking a path that is different from the norm. Discernment gives you the courage to stand firm in your convictions, even when others doubt or question your choices. It helps you to remain true to your spiritual values and to trust that God's guidance will always lead you in the right direction, even if it's not the most obvious or conventional path. Another key to discernment is being aware of spiritual distractions and deceptions. These can take many forms, from people who appear to have good intentions but are actually leading you away from your purpose, to opportunities that seem beneficial but are ultimately not aligned with your spiritual growth. Discernment allows you to recognize these distractions for what they are, to see through the illusions, and to stay focused on your true path. It's about being vigilant and mindful, always seeking the deeper truth and not being swayed by superficial appearances or short-term gains. Discernment also involves recognizing the importance of timing. Just because something is good doesn't mean it's good for you, and just because something is meant for you doesn't mean it's meant for you right now. Discernment helps you to understand the timing of God's plan for your life, to recognize when it's time to act and when it's time to wait. This is especially important when you are faced with major decisions or life changes, as it ensures that you are moving in alignment with divine timing rather than rushing ahead or lagging behind. Finally, discernment is about trusting the process, even when you don't have all the answers. There will be times when you are called to make decisions based on faith rather than certainty, to step out in trust even when the path ahead is unclear. Discernment gives you the confidence to do this, to know that as long as you are aligned with God's will, you will be guided and supported on your journey. It's about having faith in the bigger picture, knowing that every step you take is part of a divine plan, even if you can't see the full picture yet. In conclusion, spiritual discernment is an essential skill for chosen ones. It allows you to navigate your path with clarity, to recognize divine guidance, and to avoid the distractions and deceptions that can lead you astray. By developing discernment, you strengthen your connection to God, deepen your understanding of His will, and ensure that your decisions are aligned with your highest good. Embrace discernment as a vital part of your spiritual journey, and let it guide you with wisdom and confidence as you fulfill your divine purpose. Chapter 6: The Power of Faith and Surrender. As a chosen one, faith is the bedrock of your spiritual journey. It is the unwavering belief in God's plan, even when the path ahead is unclear or fraught with challenges. Faith is more than just a belief, it is an active, living trust in the divine, a confidence that no matter what happens, you are being guided and protected by a higher power. When God is trying to get your attention, He often calls you to deepen your faith, to surrender more fully to His will, and to trust in His timing and purpose for your life. Faith is what allows you to move forward, even when you don't have all the answers. It's what gives you the strength to take that leap into the unknown, trusting that the ground will appear beneath your feet as you walk. This kind of faith requires a willingness to let go of control, to release the need to understand everything, and to surrender your plans to the divine. It's about recognizing that God's perspective is far greater than your own, and that His plans for you are always for your highest good, even if they don't align with your immediate desires or expectations. Surrender is a key aspect of faith, and it's one of the most challenging spiritual practices for many chosen ones. To surrender means to release your grip on the outcome, to trust that whatever happens is part of God's divine plan. It doesn't mean giving up or being passive, rather, it's an active choice to align yourself with the flow of the universe, to cooperate with God's will rather than resisting it. Surrender is about letting go of the need to control every aspect of your life and instead, trusting that the universe is working in your favor, even when things don't seem to be going your way. One of the most profound expressions of faith is the ability to find peace in uncertainty. Life is full of unknowns, and as a chosen one, you are often called to step into situations where the outcome is far from clear. This can be daunting, but it's also an opportunity to strengthen your faith. When you trust that God is guiding your steps, you can find peace even in the midst of uncertainty. You come to realize that you don't need to have all the answers to move forward, you just need to have faith that the answers will come when the time is right. Another important aspect of faith is patience. Divine timing often doesn't align with our human timelines, and this can be frustrating. There may be times when you feel ready for something, but the doors don't open, or when you're eager for a resolution, but the situation drags on. In these moments, it's crucial to remember that God's timing is always perfect. Patience is the practice of trusting that everything is unfolding as it should, in the right time and in the right way. It's about learning to wait with grace, knowing that delays are often a part of the divine plan, designed to prepare you for what's to come. Faith also requires resilience. The path of the chosen one is not always easy, and there will be times when your faith is tested. You may face setbacks, disappointments, or challenges that shake your confidence. In these moments, it's important to remember that faith is not about avoiding difficulties, but about trusting that you will emerge stronger and wiser on the other side. Resilience is the ability to bounce back, to keep going even when the road is tough, and to maintain your faith in the face of adversity. A powerful practice for strengthening your faith is gratitude. Gratitude shifts your focus from what's lacking or uncertain to what's already present and abundant in your life. When you practice gratitude, you acknowledge the blessings that God has already bestowed upon you, and this helps to build your trust in His continued provision. Gratitude also opens your heart, making it easier to surrender and to trust that the universe is always working for your highest good. Another way to cultivate faith is through community. Surrounding yourself with like-minded individuals who share your spiritual values can provide support and encouragement on your journey. A community of faith can offer wisdom, guidance, and a sense of belonging, reminding you that you are not alone in your walk with God. Whether through a church, a spiritual group, or simply a circle of trusted friends, having a community can strengthen your faith and help you stay grounded when the path becomes difficult. In conclusion, faith and surrender are essential qualities for chosen ones. They allow you to trust in God's plan, to find peace in uncertainty, and to navigate your spiritual journey with grace and resilience. By cultivating faith, you open yourself to the flow of divine guidance and align yourself more fully with your higher purpose. Remember, faith is not just a belief, it is an active, living trust in the divine, a confidence that no matter what happens, you are being guided and protected by a higher power. Embrace faith and surrender as powerful tools on your spiritual journey, and let them guide you toward the fulfillment of your destiny as a chosen one. Chapter 7: Embracing the Journey as a Chosen One. The path of the chosen one is a unique and often challenging journey. It's a path that requires you to step into your divine purpose, to embrace your spiritual gifts, and to navigate the complexities of life with a deep sense of faith and trust in God's plan. As a chosen one, you are called to live in a way that is aligned with your higher self, to make choices that reflect your spiritual values, and to fulfill the mission that God has placed in your heart. This journey is not always easy, but it is deeply rewarding, offering opportunities for growth, transformation, and a profound connection with the divine. One of the most important aspects of embracing your journey as a chosen one is recognizing that you are not alone. Even though your path may feel solitary at times, you are always supported by the divine, by your spiritual guides, and by the community of chosen ones who share similar experiences. It's important to remember that your journey is part of a larger divine plan, and that every step you take is contributing to the greater good, even if you can't always see the full picture. Another key to embracing your journey is understanding that it's a process, not a destination. The spiritual path is a lifelong journey of learning, growth, and evolution. There will be times of clarity and times of confusion, moments of joy and moments of struggle. It's important to approach your journey with a sense of curiosity and openness, allowing yourself to learn from every experience, whether positive or negative. Each challenge you face is an opportunity to deepen your faith, to strengthen your spiritual muscles, and to move closer to your true self. As a chosen one, you are called to be a light in the world. This means that your journey is not just about your own growth and fulfillment, but also about how you can serve others. Whether through your words, your actions, or simply your presence, you have the ability to inspire, uplift, and guide those around you. Embracing your role as a light worker means recognizing the impact you can have on the world and taking responsibility for the energy you bring into every situation. It's about living in a way that reflects your spiritual values and being a source of love, compassion, and wisdom for others. Part of embracing your journey is also accepting the challenges that come with being a chosen one. The path is not always easy, and you may face opposition, misunderstandings, or even isolation. It's important to remember that these challenges are part of the process, designed to help you grow and evolve. Rather than seeing them as obstacles, view them as opportunities to strengthen your faith, to refine your character, and to deepen your connection with the divine. Embrace the challenges as a vital part of your spiritual journey, knowing that they are helping to shape you into the person you are meant to be. Another important aspect of your journey is the need for balance. As a chosen one, it can be easy to become consumed by your spiritual path, to focus so intently on your mission that you neglect other aspects of your life. However, balance is crucial for your well-being. It's important to take care of your physical, emotional, and mental health, to nurture your relationships, and to find joy and fulfillment in all areas of your life. By maintaining balance, you ensure that you are fully equipped to fulfill your divine purpose, bringing your whole self to your spiritual journey. One of the greatest gifts of embracing your journey as a chosen one is the deep sense of fulfillment that comes from living in alignment with your higher self. When you are connected to your purpose, when you are living in a way that reflects your spiritual values, you experience a profound sense of peace and contentment. This doesn't mean that life will be free of challenges, but it does mean that you will have a deep well of inner strength and resilience to draw from, allowing you to navigate any difficulties with grace and confidence. As you continue on your journey, it's important to celebrate your progress. Take time to acknowledge the growth and transformation you have experienced, to honor the milestones you have reached, and to appreciate the wisdom and insights you have gained. Celebrating your journey is not about being prideful, it's about recognizing the hard work and dedication you have put into your spiritual path. It's about giving yourself credit for the steps you have taken, and using that acknowledgement as fuel to continue moving forward. Finally, embracing your journey as a chosen one means trusting in the process, even when you don't have all the answers. There will be times when the path ahead is unclear, when you are called to step into the unknown, or when you face challenges that seem insurmountable. In these moments, it's important to trust that you are exactly where you need to be, that every experience is part of your divine plan, and that you are being guided every step of the way. Trust in the process, and know that as long as you are aligned with your higher self and following your divine purpose, you will be supported, protected, and guided on your journey. In conclusion, the journey of the chosen one is a sacred and unique path, filled with opportunities for growth, transformation, and a deep connection with the divine. By embracing your journey with faith, balance, and trust, you can navigate the challenges and joys of your spiritual path with confidence and grace. Remember, you are not alone on this journey, you are always supported by the divine, and your path is part of a greater plan. Embrace your journey, and let it lead you to the fulfillment of your divine purpose as a chosen one. As we come to the end of this episode, it's important to take a moment to reflect on the journey we discussed. The signs, the challenges, the faith required, all of these are part of your unique path as a chosen one. If you've made it this far, it's not by chance. God is indeed trying to get your attention, and this message is meant for you. You've been called to recognize the divine signs in your life, to embrace your spiritual journey with faith, and to trust in the process, even when it's difficult. Remember, you are not alone. You are part of a greater plan, a plan that is unfolding with each step you take. The universe is always guiding you, always supporting you, and always working for your highest good. Now, it's time to take action. If this episode resonated with you, if you felt that deep connection with the message, then you're on the right path. Embrace that feeling, let it fuel your faith, and continue to walk your path with confidence and trust in the divine. Before you go, I encourage you to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment with the number 77. By doing so, you are sending a signal to the universe that you are ready to fully embrace your journey as a chosen one. And don't forget, playing this video on repeat, even in the background, allows all the energy from the message to gather and be sent out to the universe, amplifying the guidance and support you'll receive. Thank you for being here, for listening, and for embracing your role as a chosen one. Remember, you are unique, you are powerful, and you are exactly where you need to be. Trust in the process, keep your faith strong, and let your light shine brightly in the world. Until next time, stay blessed and continue to follow the signs that are guiding you on your divine path.